Why do patients sue doctors or nurses or clinics?
There's a whole raft of reasons.
And I think actually that leads nicely into sort of our topic of the day. And, you know, I was thinking about this when we were planning, you know, questions and topics. Like, unless you have basically been sued or been in that scenario, why would you know about it? Like, why would you know the intricacies, the terminology and what to do? Whereas, you know, for medicine, most people have been to a doctor. Everyone's been to a doctor. You have some idea of that consultation, what goes on. You get pills or you go to a physio, and it doesn't seem that alien. But I think if I had to engage with a lawyer because someone sued me, I would literally be starting from scratch, because touch wood, thank God I haven't been in that situation yet. So yeah, maybe that sort of leads us nicely into, why do patients sue doctors or nurses or clinics?
There's a whole raft of reasons. I'll tell it from my perspective. My parents are both doctors. My relatives are doctors. I grew up around doctors. And doctors are, without a shadow of a doubt, some of the most hardworking, decent people you'll meet. The myth that doctors go into medicine because of the money is pervasive and incorrect, because if you would make more money doing almost anything else with far less stress. And yeah, the same is to be said for nurses as well. So it's a caring profession that requires a level of love and kindness. That being said, in a profession as large as medicine, there is a group of people who are, you could call them bad actors. And they're either not, they're either unwilling to do the work properly for whatever reason. Certainly speed is something that I've seen brings a lot of doctors undone. They try to do too much in too little time. They're very poor communicators. So they might be technically excellent, but they don't communicate with their patients to a sufficient standard. And the third is they may have bitten off more than they can chew. So there's a whole raft of reasons that they may get an adverse outcome, but generally speaking, the patient that has been properly informed, the patient that has been treated with dignity and respect, is unwilling to go the next step of engaging a lawyer to bring the action. It's usually when someone's properly frustrated that they seek out someone like me.
Mm.
Right.
I mean, yeah. I guess we always tend to think of it, at least from an injectable perspective, as a bad outcome. But in your experience, I think you've already implied it's often communication and sort of a breakdown of trust, not necessarily always a bad outcome, and maybe a sort of a perception of that outcome rather than the reality. Is that right or not?
It can be both. It can be an actual bad outcome. You may have, you know, for example, created necrosis.
Sure.
Because you've injected too deep. You may have caused some form of facial paralysis. There's serious consequences and adverse effect. I think you call them adverse events under insurance terminology. But from a patient's perspective, and sometimes I think people forget this because you as a nurse or as a doctor, it's your job, I guess, to treat it with a clinical indifference because you need to be objective. It's someone's face. It's someone's day-to-day experience. And if they expected something and you didn't control their expectations properly, that is in many ways the fault of the communicator. So people don't know what they don't know. And I have found that the best communicators are the ones that tend to get in the least trouble. Because usually once the process has started and we're kind of looking and making a chronology of what's happened, when, who did what, when, you'll start to see, okay, wow, this person didn't really inform the patient of the outcomes. They were certainly not supportive when things went wrong. They ignored them. They were rude to them. They were brusque with them. All of those things add up to having a bad outcome. But it's not necessarily that the medical outcome was poor. It's that the communication broke down along the way.
Thanks so much for watching the podcast clip. You can listen to the whole audio episode of the podcast on your favorite podcast app, on Apple Podcasts or Spotify. And please also leave us a review on the podcast app.
If you like what we do, please smash the like button, consider subscribing to the channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you get notified when we release new content.